Hey everyone, I'm Shakti Vetrivel, and today I'll be doing a quick demo of Azure Service Operator for you. Azure Service Operator helps you provision Azure resources and connect your applications to them from within Kubernetes. This is great for Azure users who'd prefer to manage their public cloud resources using Kubernetes tooling and primitives, for example, kubectl. The Azure Service Operator does this using two components: the custom resource definitions, also known as CRDs, for each of the Azure services a Kubernetes user can provision. The second piece is the Kubernetes controller that manages the Azure resources that are represented by the custom resources. This controller attempts to synchronize the desired state in the custom resource with the actual state of that resource in Azure. That means creating it if it doesn't exist, updating it if it has been changed, or even deleting it. In this demo, we'll go over the installation process for Azure Service Operator in a Kubernetes cluster, provision an Azure resource group from within the Kubernetes environment, and use Azure Service Operator within VS Code using the AKS VS Code extension. So let's go ahead and get started. Here's our GitHub project that houses Azure Service Operator. In the past, we've had two versions, but today we'll be focusing on V2. Now, the main difference here in version 2 is that it supports code-generated CRDs based on Azure OpenAPI specifications. This allows us to really quickly add any new resources as soon as they're requested by users. And it also gives us better uniformity across all of the Azure resources. So let's go ahead and take a closer look at version 2. Today, the project is in an alpha. We follow the Kubernetes definition of alpha. We also have a list of the different Azure resources we currently support in version 2. You can take a look at these sample YAML files we have, or sample definitions for these Azure resources. Here's one for storage accounts. So you can see we have our location, the SKU type, the name, every parameter that you need when initially creating a storage account. So with that, I'm gonna head over to VS Code to show you a bit about the AKS VS Code extension. So I already have this installed in VS Code, and this allows you to do a few different things. You can view your AKS clusters in the Kubernetes extension Cloud Explorer, add your AKS clusters to the kubeconfig in your environment, run diagnostics checks, etc. But today I'll be talking about installing Azure Service Operator on your AKS cluster. So over here, I can see the subscriptions that I have in Azure. And I already have a Kubernetes cluster up and running called ASO Demo. So I'm going to merge this into the kubeconfig for my local environment. And you can see that the cluster, along with all of its cluster information, pops up in the Kubernetes extension. Now, using the AKS VS Code extension, I'm going to go ahead and install Azure Service Operator. Through the VS Code extension, we have a pretty simple wizard for the installation. All I need to do is provide the details for a service principal that has contributor permissions for the subscription. This is what allows Azure Service Operator to create and manage resources in your subscription on your behalf. So I've already created a service principal with the necessary permissions. I'm going to go ahead and copy and paste that information into this window. Gonna go ahead and hit submit and start that installation process. So over here in the right hand corner, you can see all of the steps starting to take place for Azure Service Operator installation. And once that's complete, you'll get the full output of what's happened. So now that our installation was successful, let's go ahead and take a look at what is running in the operator's namespace. So we're still waiting for the CLI to pick up this change. But in the meantime, let's go ahead and check out the namespaces section of the Kubernetes extension. Here we see that the operator's namespace does indeed exist. We'll double click on that, get some details about the namespace. Nothing really going on in here quite yet. And if we go ahead and check the log output, we'll see that the operator's namespace was indeed created as the last step of the installation. So let's go ahead and run that command again. We see that we have two pods running as a part of the Azure Operator Controller Manager. So now that we have the operator running, let's take a look at an example of actually using the operator. So I already have a YAML definition for an Azure resource group. I'll go ahead and open that up. You'll see here the definition's pretty basic. I've got the resource group name and the location. So we're going to create a resource group called ASO Sample RG in West Central US. Now, in order to create this resource group, I'm just going to use kubectl apply and apply this YAML definition. And then the Azure Operator Controller will pick up that information and create a resource group in my Azure subscription that matches this Kubernetes object. Now let's take a look at the details of the resource group Kubernetes object that was created by the ASO controller. So we see that it has all of the details that we specified. It has the name, its location is indeed in West Central US. Just for confirmation, let's take a look at the Azure resource that this Kubernetes object represents. So in the Azure portal, I can see I have a few resource groups under my subscription, and ASO Sample RG is indeed one of them. And it's got that West Central US location that we specified. So cleanup is also very easy in Azure Service Operator. All we're going to do is delete the Kubernetes object that backs that Azure resource, and it will also delete that object in Azure as well. So I'm going to go ahead, kubectl delete resource group slash ASO sample RG. Let's open the Azure portal back up, refresh the page, and we see that the resource indeed no longer exists. So that's how Azure Service Operator works within the AKS VS Code extension. In this demo, we looked at how Azure Service Operator abstracts the Azure-specific knowledge needed to use Azure resources. This does this by simplifying Azure resources to YAML definitions and allows you to easily provision and bind resources to your AKS cluster. In version 2, by using code generation to create custom resource definitions, we now have easy maintenance and support of a wide range of Azure resources. And through the AKS VS Code extension, we can now have development and creation of Azure resources through these YAML definitions live side by side in VS Code. If you'd like to learn more about Azure Service Operator, check out our GitHub repository, which has more documentation and our product roadmap. If you'd like to learn more about Kubernetes on Azure or see more demos from this event, check out the links below.